Hey folks, Crazy Clamorator here again, and this time we're going to look at a game called Andro Dunos, which was created by Visco in 1992 for the NEO GEO cabinet. This game was requested by YouTube user and NEO GEO enthusiast Charlie Cat. But yeah, this was created for the NEO GEO cabinet, also known as the MVS. And this is a very, very nice vertically scrolling and horizontally scrolling shooter. And there's really nice power-ups, really good graphics and music. Just great to play. So check it out if you haven't heard of it before and you like Neo Geo games. Neo Geo was really, really good at the shoot-em-ups or shmups. And this one is no exception. The ships are kind of cutesy, but the rest of the graphics are really nice in this game. See, you can get these charge shots, and you have limited use of them. You just hold down the fire button and then release after a short while, and you'll have a really powerful shot. And those can lay waste to the bosses. There will be boss fights later on. But you can continue as much as you like, as long as you have credits, and you'll pick up right where you left off. Yeah. You fire and you hold down to release a heavy blast. And with the other button, there's a shot button and then there's a second button, and that button will allow you to switch between the different weapons. Yep, you can carry multiple weapons at once and switch off to them to the other ones whenever you like. Pretty nice. And they each have a different type of charge shot. We'll go ahead and get started. Graphics on this game are just really nice. The music is great. See, I'm switching over to a laser. There is a type 1 kind of shot, there is a type 2 kind of shot, a type 3 kind of shot, and a type 4 kind of shot. Type 1 is blue, I think, and type 2 is orange, type 3 is yellow, and type 4 is green. it seems that when you get enough of power-ups, which are weapon power-ups are gained by destroying certain enemies that will release a capsule that says S. That capsule says M, and that will give you missiles with your weapon. There will also be little B bubbles that you can collect, like that one. All those do are give you bonus points at the end of a level. Once you beat boss, you get a bonus for each B bubble that you collected. This game is very, very, very cool. Very beautiful graphics. You can also collect little options. And I think it said O or something on the on certain icons that are released from certain enemies when you destroy them. And those just act as shields. And they can protect your rear, and I think sometimes they can protect your front if they're in front. Depends perhaps on which side you touch the option bubble from. Whether you'll get them on the front or the back. But they, unfortunately, don't take much damage before they're destroyed. Oops, crap. Back right into that blast. And there is a red B. That can also change into a missile. But if you collect the red B, I believe that gives you another charge shot. And again, the charge shot, You just hold the fire button down for a short while and then release. Well, watch out for these guys. And it'll be a huge blast, and it's very effective against a lot of bosses. There are a total of, I believe, 7 levels. Love the graphics, the surface of the moon here. And I guess Mars in the background, maybe? But this game is just great. I never saw this in arcades. I'd heard of the name before, but never really played it much. And now that I'm playing it now, I can really appreciate its graphics and its gameplay. It's kind of challenging. Here is the first boss. He's this little core, this rotating core. Watch out. He has a little circular pattern. Don't get caught in it or you're dead. And switching over to laser. But yeah, you shoot the core when his parts scatter. You can actually sneak in a shot even while he's moving around the screen, but stay off the left side of the screen when he's moving around. But this laser is very useful against him. And there, he's dead. Stage clear, and see, I get a bonus for each B bubble I picked up. I picked up 5 of them, so I get 5,000 points. And now I'm going to the second level. Mechanized unit. Yeah, this has great graphics. Visco, I'm not sure what all else they did other than Neo Mr. Do. Neo Mr. Do is kind of a fun reboot of the Mr. Do first game. But I'm not sure what else Visco did. But yeah, the graphics are really nice. The music is great. The weapon power-ups are nice. So there's a charge shot for that shot that I've got right now. But yeah, for the Type 1, it can be either normal shot, missiles, homing, or rolling. I'm not quite sure what all of those mean. But anytime you collect the S icon from a certain defeated enemy, that'll increase the strength of the shot of the weapon that you have. If you touch that yellow beam, don't worry, you won't die. I tried to destroy it. You don't need to. You'll just get sucked up towards the wall or the ceiling or the floor. If you touch the walls or the ceiling or the floor, you die. Touch any enemy or touch their projectiles, you die. This gets tough. You do have shots where you can fire up and down if you get like an upgrade for the laser, I believe, and you might be able to take out those cannons. Otherwise, just kind of try your best to weave in between their fire. I can't believe I was able to stay alive for as long as I did there. And then there's this bastard. He'll move forward a good deal, so it's really hard not to get hit at times. Oh, and I backed right into a wall, and it's game over. I decided to continue here. Oh, and I got the shield, guys, and there's my charge shot for this. But yeah, your shield does not last very long at all, so don't count on it to save your bacon. That was just a sub-boss. So if you're a Neo Geo enthusiast, you definitely want to check out Andro Dunos. I'm not sure if it's pronounced Andro Dunos or Andro Dunos. I'll just call it Andro Dunos. It's kind of a strange name. I don't know why they went with that name, but it's a fun shooter. The option bubbles, or the B bubbles, will try to follow you. If it goes off the screen, it'll try to come back to you, which is kind of nice. There, I got another charged shot. Yeah, this is a good shoot 'em up. There will be times when, yeah, you scroll vertically, but usually it's a horizontally scrolling shooter. Now here is the second boss. I used a charged shot on him. I guess you can destroy the ceiling and the floors. But make sure you position yourself so you don't get squished. There, I beat him. And we're gonna go on to level 3. Alien, stage 3. They're coming out with another Alien movie. I might be tempted to go see it. I almost never go to movie theaters anymore just because it's so damn expensive. Whoa! That's not fair. You have to shoot those things enough. And they're really hard to bring down, and they fly at you real quick. But that is Andro Dunos, and we will look at glimpses, at least, of the rest of the levels. But like I said, I think there's a total of 7 levels. That's what it's like to put in your initials. And now let's pick up from where I left off. I put on invincibility at this point. But yeah, those guys are just... they take too many shots to bring down. And they come at you real quick. That sucks. There's the charge shot for that weapon. After I beat the game, I'll show you the weapons that are all the way powered up. But yeah, I'm using invincibility from this point on. So, shrimp-like guys. And then there's these weird guys that flick their tongues out at you. They're like hummingbirds or something? Or I don't know. At any rate, those bee bubbles, you collect those, and at the end of the level, when you beat the boss, you get a bonus for all of them. And there's another charge shot that I just picked up. And here is the boss of level 3. Really weird looking fish type thing. But he has these little arms that reach out and try to destroy you. He has a total of 3 arms. Let's use another charge shot on him. I do like that multi-laser that comes out of your body. Can do quite a bit of damage to the enemy. But yeah, you have limited charge shots. You can get more by picking up the red bee capsule that will come out of some enemies. And he's dead. And now we'll move on to stage 4. The bonus for the bee bubbles increases for each level, it looks like, by 1,000. Stage 4, Kevin. Whoops, I think they meant to say cavern. And there's another charge shot I picked up. But yeah, you can switch between the different type weapons, and you see all of them that are available at the top. And you just press the second button, and you'll switch to the next type. See, it says type 4. And it says next to the type what the weapon is. So I have, it's supposed to say three-way, but it's hard to say. And laser, and homing, and rear. That was a sort of mini-boss guy that takes a lot of shots to defeat. And now here is the boss. And he's a big old tank. If you go low, that flamethrower can still hit you. If you go just above ground level there. That laser might be my favorite weapon. It's very strong. It can do a lot of damage to some bosses. Switched over to another weapon. He's not done yet. These are hard to avoid. You don't know where they're gonna fall from. You have to avoid getting hit from them while shooting this guy. Just die already. The end of stage 4, was it? And now those B bubbles are worth 4,000 apiece. Yep, stage 5, meteorite. There will be meteorites that fly at you, and you have to destroy them early on in this stage. Some of them fly pretty fast. There, my laser is four-way there. And here's a sort of mini-boss. This cannon that's got pieces of meteor surrounding it. There's another B-bubble. Another shot power-up. And sometimes you have to shoot these little things that connect meteors. And here is the boss. Shoots these little rings at ya. Again, I have invincibility at this point, so I just wanted to cut through the bosses as quickly as I could, defeat the game as quickly as I could, and that's the end of that boss. And now those B bubbles are 5,000 apiece, which is really nice. Scoot ahead to level 6, or stage 6, secret base. Like I said, I think there was a total of 7 levels. Another B-bubble. Another shot power-up for the three-way or laser or whatever it was. But yeah, I'd never seen this in arcades, but it's a very good Neo Geo shooter. Those remind me of the... Oh, they don't leave you alone. They come back after you once you pass them. Those remind me of the fireball... things that are in, like, Super Mario Brothers on the lava level. Before you face Bowser. After I beat the game, I'll show you a little bit of... I put in a code to give myself the most powerful weapon upgrades. And I'll show you what that looks like later on. And again, the M means missile. That, I think, was O. That gives you the option shield guys. But they do not last very long. They cannot take very many hits. So they're not terribly useful. And here is the boss of the sixth level. Doing a charge shot on him. Yeah, if you see that little... the charge meter flicker, then you still have another charge shot on there. But yeah, you can collect more charge shots by picking up the red bee if it's if you shoot a certain enemy that will release it. Yeah, I really don't know what they Andro Dunos is supposed to mean, where they got that name. This guy has these little laser things that you have to know what their pattern is. There, I destroyed him. And now we go on to stage 7. Core. Yeah, the music is great. The graphics are great. The weapon ups are pretty nice. There's another charge shot. Yeah, that guy just takes a lot of shots to bring down. And then you have these things going on from the ceiling to the floor and back, holding down the charge shot here, and that's what that one gives. And here is almost the last boss of the game. This is a mini boss. Just have to shoot its blue core enough times to destroy it. Once you beat him, you're forced to get the hell out of there. And you have to get through these gates before they close. So you want to move towards the right. Well, maybe there's sort of eight stages. Yeah, see, I have to stay to the right. I would have been killed there, and I would have been killed there because I would have been in a dead end. But yeah, you want to get past those walls that close and those ceiling tiles or whatever that are falling down on you. If you like Neo Geo games and you like shooters, this is definitely one to look out for. It's a really good one. It can be deceptively difficult at times, even early on. We're just about to face the last boss. And you have to contend with these guys for just a moment. And he has those same guys rotating around him. They can shoot big old lasers. Want to shoot his glass dome enough times. I'm going to scoot forward. And show you what it looks like to destroy him. Then his brain, I guess, will attack you, and you have to watch out for all those pieces that fly out of him. And sometimes he'll make a beeline right at you, like there. And And there, that is the end of Andro Dunos. I'm guessing that's how it's pronounced. Maybe it's Andro Dunos. Maybe Andro Dunos. Don't know. It's a weird title, but it's a good game. Here are the credits. Ideb. Weird names. Oftentimes the Japanese at the ends of video games, they'll have silly names that they give themselves. And let's start over real quick here. I'll show you some of the best weapon power-ups for each type. Like I said, there's type 1, there's type 2, type 3, and type 4. Type 1 can be a normal shot, it can be missile, it can be homing, it can be rolling. And type 2 can be reverse, hawk missile, homing, and side. Type 3 can be laser, missile, homing, or front. Type 4 can be three-way laser, homing, and rear. And you switch between the different types by pressing the second button, B button. And with A, you just fire, or you can hold it down and release for a big shot, a charged shot, if you have any left over. And you can get extra ones by collecting a red B from certain defeated enemies. But these are the best weapon ups in the game, or the most upgraded ones. You just keep collecting the S icon from certain defeated enemies, and that will upgrade the shot that you're using. And you can collect the O from some defeated enemies that will give you two little shield guys. That's a really nice weapon up. So is that. And then you can also collect the B bubbles, which you will collect a bonus for at the end of a level, and that bonus goes up by 1,000 for each level that you've passed. And those option guys that you collect are they don't last very long. They don't get to take too many hits before they're gone. There's another charge shot up, the red beat. But yeah, if you haven't heard of this game and you like Neo Geo games, definitely give this a try. This is a good shooter. Some very cool weapon ups. Yeah, notice, see the level that I've brought each shot up to. That's like the maximum, I think, for each shot. And I got that way by putting in a code. A special cheat. But with your weapons powered up big time, you can make short work of the bosses. But those are some very nice weapon ups. The enemies shoot a lot more here because I've already beaten the game once. The difficulty increases. Wait till he stops and I'll blast him. And he's dead already. Well, that was Andro Dunos by Visco in 1992. And this was requested by YouTube user Charlie Cat. Well, this is Crazy Clam Radio saying thanks for watching Andro Dunos by Visco in 1992 for the Neo Geo cabinet. I will catch you later with another video. See you then, folks. Bye-bye.